Going back to another create tutorial. This episode, I'll be showing you guys how to create a few different farms, giving you guys the tools to either use my designs or come up with some designs of your own. This first farm I have to show you guys is a pretty basic farm. If you have seen my previous tutorial on the best crop farm in Minecraft, you might recognize this. It's just a small radial design, basically spins around collecting crops, then depositing them wherever you need them. So the way this works is basically you plant your crops and then you have this row of harvesters. What the harvesters are going to do is they're going to, as they go over full crops, we just kind of bone meal a bunch of crops here. You can see as it goes over them, they kind of get harvested. What it's going to do is it's going to put them in these chests. As it comes all the way back around, it'll go into this portable storage interface, connect, then it'll spit items out. A little more in depth, I'm just going to come down here, turn it off. I'll show you guys how it's put together. So the way this design is put together is, if I kind of break this and show you guys what's going on. To generate the power, we simply have a campfire and a fan. The way this works is you have a fan facing the campfire. The way that works is when you give redstone power to the fan, it's going to start turning. And on the back of the fan, there is a shaft, and that actually creates some rotational power you can use for whatever you need it for. I'm going to grab my bearing and put it back, which is the next item, which is the mechanical bearing. What this does is when it gets rotational power in from the bottom, this top plate will actually rotate. And coming up here, we have two radial chassis to kind of get it up to the surface level of our farm. Basically what these do is they will connect this whole line, and basically it works like that. If I wanted to create another line, I can show you guys how it was made. Basically, all you need to do is you need to grab a slime ball, right click on one of these faces where you can kind of see the wood texture, and then I can kind of place these, and the linear chassis will all actually connect together without needing to be slimed. Those will connect together. If I grab my harvesters, what I can do is then I can use slime and glue them to the surface of the chassis. And the final two items on this are our chests, which are just, again, glued to the linear chassis here, as well as a portable storage interface. Now, basically what this does is it actually takes the items from those chests and spits it out into whatever inventory you need it to go into. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this bad boy back on. What I need to do is I need to give some redstone signal to the fan, which turns it from a fan into a small generator. You see it comes around, it's going to pick up a few crops. Then I have another portable storage interface here, which is stationary. You can see they kind of do the little animation and connect, and items get spit out of here. Now, to actually use a portable storage interface, you need to either have a funnel coming off to the side with a belt, or alternatively, you can either use a chute or a hopper below the interface where items will kind of drop straight down. So this one, I just have a funnel going into another funnel into this chest, and below it, another funnel is going straight down into this chest. This will work with any kind of crops, with netherwort, wheat, we got potatoes, we got carrots, we got beetroot. So anything you want to farm, you can do it with this method. Just a small footnote here, you can do the same thing with sugarcane, with the only caveat is the harvesters have to actually be one block above where your sugar cane is growing. So this next farm I have here is a pumpkin and melon farm. This is using a sticky mechanical piston. So the way that this works is to actually harvest the melons and pumpkins, you need to use these mechanical drills. Basically what a drill does is it'll break any block and collect it and put it in the inventory. So basically what we have here is we have a piston taking this whole line of linear chassis, extending out and extending back. To actually place a mechanical piston, you're going to place the piston, and then behind the piston, you're going to grab these extension poles. So if I wanted to extend this out as much as I want, I can just kind of keep going on with these extension poles. And for every block that of pole you place, it'll extend out that many blocks and out. So just kind of give you guys an example. So if we were growing some pumpkins and melons here, you can see as it runs into it, it kind of does that drill animation. And actually collects the resource. A few of those, and also I have it going back. So as the pest like re-extends back, it'll block them again. This is actually crucial because if you place just a regular block, it would stop itself. And because I'm actually stopping and not taking the items out as I'm moving, I don't need to use a portable storage interface. Alternatively, I just have an andesite funnel sitting here, which takes the items directly from that chest, because that chest actually is stationary and is actually placed down when it stops. So the items can be removed directly from the chest. Here the chest stops, the items kind of going out, get pumped out, and then into this chest at the end here. Now to actually get the back and forth motion, just kind of simple design. So basically, the way I'm doing that is with a gear shift. Try to grab a gear shift and a lever. Kind of show you guys how this works. So if a motor going to a gear shift, just grab a cog for demonstration. You see it's turning one way. Then if you give power to the gear shift, it'll turn the other way. And then what I'm doing to actually give it power is I have a small redstone clock using the create mod. So I have these adjustable repeaters set to 3 seconds each, a power toggle latch, and then a redstone link to actually get our power up there. So basically what it does a clock pulsing at each of these corners. And when it pulses into the power toggle latch, it'll actually toggle it back and forth. And as it does that, it powers and unpowers the gear shift, sending the whole piston arm forward and backwards. Next farms I have here to show you are a coca bean and a kelp farm, kind of using the same design. First one here is a coca bean farm. So this is using the same repeater clock, power toggle latch, and a gear shift. But instead of the piston, what we're using is a rope pulley. So the way a rope pulley works is when you give it power, if it's turning one way, it'll go down. If it's turning the other way, it'll go back up. I'm going to grab myself some bone meal here and grow a few of these coca beans. You can see as it goes down, it'll kind of do the same thing it does with crops, and it'll actually harvest them. I'm going to get to the bottom here. We have a funnel. As we're actually stopping at the bottom and placing this item, we're able to funnel items out directly into this chest. Yeah, I think it's a really nice, clean design. It works pretty well. So if you're trying to build a chocolate factory and you keep running out of coca beans, this would be a nice way to collect a lot of them. And this next one is a kelp farm. This is the same thing. So basically, the way this works is we have water source blocks where the kelp is growing, then not water source blocks over here. The reason we need those is as it goes down, we need to actually have an airspace here for the linear chassis to travel in. So if I were to do this mechanical crank, what this basically is, this is a way to do stuff by hand. You can see traveling down, then it'll actually stop at the bottom, place itself, and then I can hold shift and right click, and I can pull the whole machine back up with a hand crank. Get our chest, we've collected all the kelp. This is probably one of the first farms I'd recommend making, as if you're planning to build a lot of belts, having a ton of kelp is super helpful for all that belt work. Next, I have two different animal farms to show you. The first is a cow farm, the second is a sheep farm. So this cow farm that I have is going to be a fully automatic cow farm that'll get you both meat and leather. And the way that this works is we have some cows sitting on a belt, some adult cows, and I have a deployer back here. And what I can do is I can grab a few stacks of wheat, put it in this chest, and this chute will deliver it to the deployer. Then the deployer is holding the wheat and actually automatically breeding our cows. You can see as the cows are bred, the babies are taken away on the belt, dropped down into this chamber. And it works super well. This can be done with cows, it can be done with pigs, it can be done with chickens. Anything that is bred, you can actually breed using the deployers. Then our baby cows go down to this killing chamber. The way that this works is we have a saw kind of spinning around here. It is possible that it's going to hit a baby as it's going down, but it's pretty unlikely. I've only seen it happen maybe once or twice, so you're really not losing much from that. And if I were to spawn an adult cow in here, see an adult cow actually gets damaged and killed, and its meat drops below. The reason I decided to go with this saw design is I tried a few different designs with lava blades, and the big problem with that is they'll either get stacked up or you have to go and physically press a button to turn it on and off. So it didn't really work too well. I also tried a piston method, which was crushing the adult cows, but it also ended up crushing the baby cows. So this is kind of the best design I found that kills them really quickly as soon as they age. The way this works is it's very similar to the radial farm, where we have a motor powering a mechanical bearing, and above that we just have radial chassis, linear chassis, and a saw at the end. We're gonna spawn a few more adult cows. You can see they'll kind of get killed pretty quickly. And I have all the cows sitting on a chute, so all the items get dropped right through. They sit here. Now what we're doing is we're actually automatically cooking all of the meat. So as they're dropped here, what we have is we have an encased fan being powered, and we have a fire. And what the campfire is doing is it's actually creating a smoker effect here. So as they drop down, the items will be smoked, and then here on this funnel I have a filter that says I'll only accept cooked meat and leather. So none of the raw meat will actually go through into the chest, just the cooked meat and the leather. And then the next farm I have here is a automatic wool farm. Now this farm is honestly, it's probably my favorite. It's super fast, super efficient. This I would say has been running for less than an hour, and we have almost a stack of every kind of wool. If you're just looking for a single color, you can color all the sheep one color and just get a ton of wool. I think it works really well. The way this is working is we have deployers holding some shears, and we're powering those deployers, and it's automatically shearing the sheep as soon as they grow. So this is a completely tileable design. You can go out as far as you want. I have just 16 compartments for all the different colors, and basically the way it works is you have your cell with your sheep in it. You have a line of grass above, as well as a line of grass below. And the reason you want that much grass is so that way the dirt block that they're standing on is going to grow as fast as possible. You can see what happened right there is as soon as it grew its wool back, the shear kind of extended out, sheared the sheep. What it does is it actually takes that wool and puts it in the deployer's inventory. And what happens is it goes out on the funnel, which have a filter saying we will not accept shears. So it goes on the funnel and then goes out to the mechanical belt, goes down into our chest. Yeah, this design works super well. It's really fast. As soon as they have their wool, they just automatically get sheared, and it goes really well. Now if you were to put this in a survival world and you wanted to refill all of the shears, all you have to do is drop shears in each of these chutes. You could also have an automatic system using create to deliver shears as you want, but really you probably want to replace these shears too many, as one shear gives you quite a lot of wool. Now into the last section, tree farms. The first tree farm I have here is a radial design, which basically is the same as a crop farm where it kind of spins around. This is using saws instead of the harvesters to actually take down the trees. The way it works is it'll actually take down the entire tree, all of the leaves, and it'll collect all of the wood, sticks, and apples from the trees. You can see it's the same deal with the deployer on the end and some chests for storage. When it gets there, it'll kind of drop all the items down to the chute. Looks like we're actually full. This farm is super quick, it's super efficient. Really, if you could just put one of these together, you're gonna have as much of whatever kind of wood you need. Here it's actually making all the different wood types, and it's working really well. Now the one difference you might have seen as compared to the crop farm is we actually have to place our saplings back down. So the way we're doing that is we need to place the deployer, the 2-block air gap, then obviously put chassis connecting them all together. So as it goes around, if I were to just kind of break all these saplings, see as it goes around, it's actually placing those saplings back down. And the way we actually tell it what saplings to place, I can go ahead and turn it off for a second, is in the deployer, there is a small area for a filter. So what we do is we want to take our sapling, put it in that filter, then we can put up to a stack in its hand, and basically it'll say whenever it breaks a tree, it'll break all the leaves, and if it has saplings, it'll prioritize putting it in the hand versus putting it in the chest to be deposited later. And the hands can hold up to a stack of saplings, so at all times basically all these hands will be full, and it'll always be able to place the trees back down as it goes. The next tree farm we have here is a minecart contraption design. Really isn't either better or worse than the radial design. You do gain some, you do lose some. You gain some, in this case, you only need two saws, two deployers, and you can extend this out as much as you want. But my opinion, I think it looks less cool, and also I believe it's a bit less efficient in terms of how quickly it's going to collect those trees. What's really cool about this one is you can easily do some 2x2 trees, as you can see. So right now I'm just doing it with dark oak so I can collect all the different wood types, but you could also do this with tall spruce trees or tall jungle trees. Go ahead and stop this right here and I'll show you what's going on. So basically we have our deployer, our portable storage interface, which actually takes items out, puts them into this chest. And above that we have two saws, which are going to break our trees, two chests for storage, and then back here we have our deployers holding our saplings ready to plant them back down. And then basically you want to build all of that on top of a cart assembler, put a minecart in it, flick the lever, and it'll just go. And it'll keep going as long as it needs to, and it'll keep breaking the trees. Now, one really important thing I'm going to mention about both of these designs, if the chests fill up, it will continue to go and just drop the items on the floor. So especially if you're playing on a Minecraft server or this area is chunk loaded, I would highly recommend putting a comparator on this chest, or basically to say, hey, if I'm full, stop the machine, so that way you're not creating unnecessary lag by dropping a bunch of unnecessary items on the floor. And now for the last farm I have to show you guys is a warp and crimson tree farm. The way this works is, this is the only one we have to actually put in an input. It's not fully automatic. You have to input bone meal and the fungus to actually get this to work. This design would also work with mushrooms. I just didn't show that in this example, but if you had a dark room with the same design of mushrooms, it would do the same thing. But if we want to get this going, what I have here is I have a chest going into our portable storage interface. And what's cool about the portable storage interface is it's actually two ways. So if I'm pumping items into it, it will actually take items from the portable storage interface on the surface into the one on the cart. I'm just going to go ahead and put in my warp, then feed it some bone meal. See it coming out here, going into the minecart. Then I actually have two different hands, two different deployers, one placing the fungus and the one bone mealing it. See, it goes around, it's pretty quick. What I'm going to do is I'm actually speed this up. I would really highly recommend putting this on max speed. The reason for that is this warped Nihilium and the crimson Nihilium will actually, if it has a block run on top of it, it will die and just turn it into another rack. You'll have to go in and bone meal it again. So you want your outputs and inputs to be as fast as possible, so that way as you're going, you're not going to be wasting any time having to go fix these. So you can see we already had a few instances where that happened. If I want to fix those, all I need to do is I need to grab some bone meal those spots, and the Nihilium will grow back. See, it goes around, breaks the items, takes them out, and then spits them into this chest. You can see we put just 32 of the fungus in here, and we already have almost half of this chest full of warp blocks, shroom lights, and stems. So this farm is crazy fast, it's crazy efficient. You really don't need too much to get a lot of these nether trees going. Go ahead and put these on max speed too. And feed our crimson one. Okay, so you can see it just ran out. And look at what we got. We got over 3 stacks of wood. Got a ton of warp blocks and about half a stack of shroom light. So yeah, I mean this farm is just crazy efficient. It's crazy fast. Just the one caveat is you do have to go in and fix the fungus as you go, as the Nihilium, I should say. Gotta fix the Nihilium as you go to make sure that you can still plant or grow your trees, but it's really not too big of a deal. The one thing you'll notice with the crimson is it is spitting out these weeping vines. And with the way the collision works with the minecart contraptions, it's as it goes, it'll actually kind of spit out all of the vines to the edges. So if you wanted to, you could put a secondary belt system along the outside edge here and collect all of those vines. I'm going to go ahead and disassemble our warp part, show you what's going on. So basically we have two filters here, on our deployers, one saying, hey, I gotta hold bone meal, and the other saying, I gotta hold the fungus. So that's kind of how it works, and it goes around, places them, bone meals them, and gets you a ton of blocks. Thanks for watching my video, everyone. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any other tutorials you'd like to see, or you have any questions for me, go ahead and leave it down in the comment section below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please go ahead and leave a like and subscribe. I'll be trying to release one of these videos every week for the next few weeks to teach you guys as much about the Create Mod as I can. Alright, thank you everyone for watching. Bye-bye.